राइट ऑन पॉइंट नंबर सिक्स कि डी रिकॉग्निशन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल लायबिलिटी बाय इश्यू ऑफ व्हाट इक्विटी शेयर्स नथिंग बताओ ओनली वन पॉइंट फाइनेंशियल लायबिलिटी विल बी डी रिकॉग्नाइज and equity will be recognized at its fair value correct any difference is gain or loss on derecognition which is transferred to what PL bas simple means what journal entry will do financial liability account debit correct with settlement amount to equity at fair value difference will be what difference is recognizing PL once again I have written to equity this is as per Ind AS but as per Companies Act it should be equity say capital and difference should be adjusted in other equity correct now because I have written fair value I have not written face value fair value but as per Companies Act we should write on equity share capital correct now so this journal entry is as per Ind AS not as per Companies Act Ind AS does not deal with face value okay correct so this journal entry is from Ind AS point of view not from Companies Act point of view correct now well are you understanding what I am saying there is one illustration given in institute book only that only will take come to page number 56 one example is given that example will take example given in page number 56 this is given in this whatever I am doing this is appendix D of Ind AS 109 correct now so we'll take one question JK Limited you have understood example at the end example number is not given page number 56 JK Limited has an outstanding unsecured loan of rupees 90 crore to a bank the effective EIR of the loan is 10% owing to financial difficulty JK Limited is unable to service the debt and approach the bank for a settlement the bank offer the following terms which are accepted by JK Limited 60% of debt is unsustainable and hence will be converted into 70% equity interest in JK Limited. 70% equity interest in JK Limited. The fair value of net asset of JK Limited is 80 crore. Means can I say, when I am saying the 60% of debt 60% of debt means 60% of 90 crore means how much? How much? 60% of 90 crore is equal to 54 crore. 54 crore. Correct. Will be converted into what? Equity. And they will be given 70% of interest in JK Limited, and the total net assets is 80 crore. So what is the fair value of equity shares issued? Is equal to 80 crore into what? 70% is equal to what? How much? 56. Is equal to 56. This point you understood? Correct? Any doubt? So this is the first part. Second part, what they have said, 40% of debt is sustainable. Sustainable means it can be paid by that company. And the bank agreed to certain moratorium period. What is the meaning of moratorium period? Means some grace period and decrease in interest rate in initial period. So what is the 40% of debt? 40% of debt is equal to 40% of 90 crore. That is 36. Correct? Understood? The present value of cash flow as per this revised terms calculated using original EIR. So they have given present value of contractual cash flow under what? Under modified terms is equal to what? 25 crore. Under modified terms, sorry, discounted at using what? Discounted by using original EIR. So we want this to find out whether the terms are substantially different or not. They have given for that reason. And the fair value of cash flow as per the revised term. So what is the fair value of contract, this present value under market rate of interest? That is the fair value of loan. So what is the fair value of loan as per modified terms? As per modified terms is equal to 28 crore. Of course, this will be discounted at what? This is discounted at market rate of interest. Market rate of interest. Fair value of consideration paid is 56 crore. That is 70% of 80 crore plus. Actually, the question is thoda sa wrong. Understood? That is, initially they have given 60%, then they are saying 70%. Chika na? Understood? 70% of 80 crore is how much? And 60% of 90 crore? 60% of 90 crore? 54. So, chhod do that. Now, don't read the question, okay? Now this is the entire thing. Okay, then whatever I am doing, that is done. Means they have taken initially in the question, they have given 60% of debt, then they are saying 70% of 80 crore. 70% kahan se aaya? 80 crore is what? Huh? What 70%? अच्छा, they are taking that. So, ठीक है. Then, two-third, the question is wrong. उसको छोड़ दो. ठीक है? Solution is wrong. So, now we are coming to what? Settlement. Means, settlement journal entry. Settlement journal entry. So, first we are doing for what? कि सेटलमेंट बाय इश्यू ऑफ व्हाट इक्विटी शेयर्स, सेटलमेंट बाय इश्यू ऑफ इक्विटी शेयर्स, तो 60% ऑफ डेट विल बी कन्वर्टेड, करेक्ट ना? करेक्ट, तो बताओ व्हाट विल जना एंट्री, जना एंट्री व्हाट, लोन अकाउंट डेबिट हाउ मच, लोन अकाउंट डेबिट व्हाट इज द कैरिंग अमाउंट, व्हाट इज द कैरिंग अमाउंट, ऑलरेडी वी हैव डन 54 टू इक्विटी, व्हाट इज द फेयर वैल्यू, हाउ मच, 56, डिफरेंस इज व्हाट, व्हाट लॉस, तो लॉस इज हाउ मच, लॉस ऑन सेटलमेंट अकाउंट डेबिट 2 crore, दिस यू अंडरस्टूड फर्स्ट, देन सेटलमेंट या मॉडिफिकेशन, देन सेकेंड पोर्शन इज मॉडिफिकेशन, मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ 40% ऑफ डेट, 40% ऑफ डेट, तो फर्स्ट वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट वेदर इट इज सब्सटेंशियली डिफरेंट और नॉट, सब्सटेंशियली डिफरेंट टर्म्स और नॉट, करेक्ट, तो फर्स्ट वील डू एनालिसिस ऑफ व्हाट, एनालिसिस ऑफ सब्सटेंशियल डिफरेंट टर्म्स, करेक्ट, तो व्हाट इज ए, ए इज इक्वल टू व्हाट, प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्चुअल कैश फ्लो अंडर मॉडिफाइड टर्म्स, अंडर मॉडिफाइड टर्म्स, डिस्काउंटेड बाय यूजिंग व्हाट, डिस्काउंटेड बाय यूजिंग विच रेट, using what, original, original EIR plus legal fee paid, but they have not given any legal fee in this question, plus legal fee paid, so they have already given 25 crore, so I am writing 25 crore directly, correct, then B will be what, carrying amount of what, existing liability, existing liability, that is 40% of what, 90 crore, so 40% 90 crore, how much, 36, difference is equal to what, difference is equal to what, difference 11. The difference will take in absolute terms. What is the meaning of absolute terms? Means without taking negative into consideration. Correct na? So difference will always take in absolute terms. Are you getting? So difference 11. So now we'll find out what? 10% of this is what? A minus B. Then we'll do 10% of B. 10% of B is what? 3.6. Therefore, A minus B in absolute term is more than what? 10% of B. So it means what? It means modified terms are substantially different. Understood? So always this difference should be in absolute terms. Because negative cannot be what? Compared. Negative cannot be compared. Can I say if the liability is decreasing, then also it can be what? Substantially different. Are you getting what I am saying? If liability is decreasing, then also it can be substantially different. ठीक है ना, तो ऑलवेज ए माइनस बी विल बी टेकन एज ए एब्सोल्यूट फिगर नॉट इन नेगेटिव टर्म्स. इफ यू टेक नेगेटिव टर्म्स देन डाउट विल कम कि सर देन तो ए माइनस बी इज लेस देन व्हाट 10% ऑफ बी. बट कैन आई से इवन दो लायबिलिटी इज डिक्रीजिंग देन ऑल्सो इट कैन बी सब्सटेंशियली डिफरेंट. करेक्ट, तो ऑलवेज दिस विल बी टेकन इन एब्सोल्यूट टर्म्स नॉट इन नेगेटिव फिगर. अंडरस्टूड दिस पॉइंट? तो मॉडिफिकेशन टर्म्स आर सब्सटेंशियली डिफरेंट, देयरफॉर विल फॉलो व्हाट, फॉलो एक्सटिंग्विशमेंट एक्सटिंग्विशमेंट अकाउंटिंग. तो बताओ व्हाट विल बी द जर्नल एंट्री फॉर दिस, बताओ विल राइट डाउन व्हाट, लोन ओल्ड इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच, हाउ मच इट इज 40%, गिव मी इट इज 36 टू लोन न्यू, बट इट विल कम एट फेयर वैल्यू. What is the fair value of loan given? 28. Fair value of loan to bank, there is no legal fee. There is no legal fee. The difference will be what? Loss or gain? So there is a gain. So gain on settlement, yeah, gain on derecognition, yeah, gain on extinguishment. Whatever you want to write down, better write down gain on extinguishment. Correct. Will be equal to how much? 36 minus 28, 8. This will be transferred to PL. This will be transferred to PL. Understood? Don't read solution because 60% they have taken 2/3. I don't understand where, how they have taken 2/3. So solution delete, follow my solution. Okay? Delete a solution, follow my solution. Understood? So this though you are already knowing, this is not a new point. This is not a new point. New point is what? This. Ki if it is what? Settled by issue of equity shares, then what will be the journal entry? Common sense. This is the journal entry, common sense. But if you want to write down at what? As per Companies Act, so this will be 2 equity share capital at face value. But since they have not given face value, hence we cannot write down. And the balance will be adjusted with other equity. The balancing figure will be adjusted in other equity. Correct? Understood? So if you want to follow Companies Act, then the equity share capital should come at face value, not at fair value. Not at fair value. So if the information is given that equity shares has this much face value, then write down this journal entry. If the information is not given, then write down 2 equity only. 2 equity. Understood this point? So this is what? All the derecognition point of financial liability over. Derecognition over. Any doubt? Till now derecognition done. So what we have done? We have done financial asset, financial liability, we have done what? Recognition, initial recognition, subsequent recognition, reclassification, derecognition. Similarly for financial liability also we have done. Only one point is left, that is impairment. Impairment is left. So impairment will be done, then the financial asset and financial liability will be over. Then we can start what? Derivative financial instrument. Derivative financial instrument. So you can see one chapter, so many points. One chapter is what? Full one syllabus. Means there can be 100 marks question from this chapter in exam if they want to ask. In this one chapter can be one subject. If they want to ask, they can ask 100 marks question from this chapter only. But they will not do. They will ask only what? 10 marks question. For 10 marks now revision become difficult. If you say the question will come for 40 marks, this is very simple chapter. But now only 10 marks question will be asked. Now we don't know which topic they are going to ask. It means frustration level will increase when you will do revision. When you will do revision, pakka in this chapter, if you revise after 2-3 months, then the frustration level will be at highest level. What is going on? Kya ho raha hai? Because dekho, but if you take point by point, concept by concept, then it is very simple. One concept, one concept, one concept. It will, if you'll do in that way, It is very simple chapter. But if you take it together as one chapter and 10 marks, you will consider ki from this chapter 10 marks is going to come. This will become heavy. So I will say when you are doing this chapter, don't think about marks. Think, go for what concept, 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 you will be able to understand very easily. Correct? So can we start impairment? What was the point number for derecognition? What was the point number for, we started financial liability. What was the financial liability point? I think 2. So can we take 3? Roman 3 or? Roman 3. Write down 3. Write down impairment. Impairment of. Impairment of course financial asset. Not financial liability. Financial asset na. Impairment. So we have done impairment of PP. Impairment of PP was covered where? Ind AS 36. We have an impairment of intangible asset. Cover where? Impairment of PP. Covered where? Ind AS 36. Impairment of intangible asset. Ind AS? Give me poison. Ind AS 36 only, Baba. One second. Impairment of PP is covered where? Impairment of intangible asset. Impairment of investment property. Are Baba, that is also 36. 40. 40 is for impairment. Mother, I'll kill you. What we are doing, we have done that chapter, we have written under scope ki what are covered, what are not covered. But just try to understand, all will mix. Financial asset will become fixed asset because we are writing FA. So if I write FA, achha, this will include PP, intangible asset, everything it will include. Maja aa raha hai. India statistics delete karo. Means just try to understand what is going on. Property, plant and equipment, which Ind AS? 36. Intangible asset, which Ind AS? 36. Investment property, which Ind AS? 36. Investment in associate, subsidiary, joint venture. I have given indicator, but we have not discussed it. We have not discussed it. Bula, kahan discussion karenge? In consolidation chapter. This is also covered under Ind AS 36. Impairment of inventory is covered where? Ind AS 2. Impairment of inventory is covered under Ind AS 2. That is cost price or NRV, whichever is lower. That is nothing but impairment. Correct. For biological asset, we have started Ind AS 41. So for this, no specific Ind AS. Why? Because biological asset are initially measured at fair value. Initially measured at fair value. So now what is left? Left is financial asset. You can see. What is left? Financial asset is left. Now financial asset will include other investment also. So these are two investment. Investment property, investment is. So all other investment and also all receivable. Receivable means what? Receivable means what? Any trade receivable, any loan receivable, any whatever. Correct. So can I say the financial asset means what? Investment. It will be any receivable. Receivable means loan receivable, trade receivable, lease receivable also. So impairment of lease receivable will be also covered where? Under Ind AS 109. However, the recognition and measurement of lease receivable is covered under Ind AS 17. Impairment of lease receivable. Impairment nothing but provision for doubtful debt. Means we are discussing a provision for doubtful debt. The impairment is nothing but provision for doubtful debt, but now we'll not call it for doubtful debt when we are in Ind AS. Okay? Will not use that word. Okay? So can I say it will cover all other assets which are financial asset. Which are financial asset. Now you know what is financial asset. You know what is financial asset. So write down point number one. An entity self recognize a loss allowance. Check karo, they have written loss allowance. They have not written provision for doubtful debt. However, when I started Ind AS 37, I said provision for doubtful debt is the wrong term because provision is liability. And this impairment is not a liability. You remember when I started Ind AS 37? I already said provision for doubtful debt is the wrong term. Entities have recognized a loss allowance for what? Expected credit loss. We'll call it ECL. Expected credit loss. ECL. On the following. Point number A. Financial asset that are measured at amortized cost. Correct? Point number B. Financial asset that are measured at what? FVTOCI. And point number C, lease receivable. So lease receivable has been considered separately. Lease receivable is considered separately, correct? But if you think lease receivable is nothing but amortized cost, yaad karo, that table only we do. Year end, opening obligation, that is also one type of amortized cost only. Correct na? But we don't say there, we have not used the word amortized cost under Ind AS 17. Okay? Therefore, they have specifically written lease receivable. Correct? What is not written? Financial asset measured at FVTPL are not required to be tested for what? To be tested for impairment. Why? Already at fair value and charged to PL. FVTOCI is also fair value, but it has not been charged to PL. Is not tested for impairment. Understood? Point number two. Credit loss allowance. Point number one. Calculate contractual cash flow that entity is not expected to receive. So we need to find out contractual cash flow that entity is not expected to receive. Can I say this is the difference between what? Between point number A, contractual cash flow that are due to an entity under the contract, and point number B, cash flow that the entity expected to receive, correct? So this is the difference between A and B. This is what due. Check out the word is what due. This is what expected to receive. Okay. Then we'll find out point number two. Calculate present value of cash flow calculated under step one. Calculated under step one by using which EIR? By using original EIR. By using original EIR. Correct? Understood? In this two, no doubt. Then write down. Point number three. Calculation of credit loss allowance. In this item, point number one. If 12-month ECL means expected credit loss. ECL means what? Expected credit loss. If 12-month ECL is measured, then credit loss allowance will be equal to present value of cash flow in step number 2 multiplied by PD means probability of default. I will write down PD in next 12 month. Just write down, even though you are not answering. PD means probability of default. I will write down PD. PD in next 12 month. PD in next 12 month. If lifetime ECL is measured. Lifetime ECL is measured. Now your dimag is ghuming. What is this? Correct? Now I have no option either to do or do. Every point is new. Each and every point is new. Correct? Now I said already before starting, I said this chapter can be one subject. Correct? Credit loss allowance will be equal to present value of cash flow calculated in step number 2 into probability of default over lifetime, over lifetime of financial asset. Give star mark. Let PD means what? Probability of default. Correct. This you understood? Not understood, of course. Write down. How the loss allowance is provided? Is write down. If financial asset is a trade receivable, write down in the way I am writing. Trade receivable or lease receivable. Or any other contract asset operating. Correct? Yes. Measure lifetime ECL. ECL means what? Expected credit loss. No. Has the credit risk, means if it is not a trade receivable, if it is not a lease receivable, it is not any other operating receivable. Correct? Understood? So then ask one question. Has the credit risk increased significantly for financial asset? If the answer is yes, then once again we'll measure what? Lifetime expected credit loss. If the answer is no, then we'll measure what? Then measure 12-month. Measure 12-month expected credit loss. Correct? Of course, you have not understood anything. Correct now. Have you understood? Bolo. Look. Point number 4. I am just giving writing. I will explain everything. Don't worry. Yeah? General 3-stage approach. Not applicable for trade receivable. Receivable and lease receivable. and lease receivable. Correct? So what is the three stage approach? Stage one, credit risk has not increased significantly, since initial recognition, then recognize 12-month expected credit loss. Interest income is recognized on gross amount. Just write down. I know you are understanding everything. You are not understanding, I know. Correct. I am just giving writing. Maja aa raha. Credit risk has increased significantly since initial recognition, then recognize lifetime ECL. Lifetime ECL, interest income is recognized on gross amount. Stage 3, your credit impaired financial asset. Correct. Credit impaired financial asset means there is an indicator of actual loss now. Indicator for actual loss. Then recognize lifetime ECL. Now you must be thinking, what is the difference between stage number 2 and stage number 3? Correct? So in this, write down, interest income is recognized on net amount. Correct. Note number 1. 12-month ECL means what? Are calculated by multiplying the PD. PD means probability of default occurring in the next 12 month with total lifetime expected credit loss that would result from that default regardless when such loss actually occur. Therefore, 12-month ECL represent a financial asset lifetime expected credit loss that are expected to occur within 12 months within 12-month period from each reporting date of those assets. Understanding? Not understanding. Correct? Chalo. We'll take a break. After break, we'll continue the writing and then explanation. Okay? We'll take a break of 10 minutes. Done? Chalo. Can we start once again? Everyone. So, before break, we are doing impairment of financial asset. I have given only in writing. So, I was giving note number 1. Note number 1 you have written, write down note number 2. Entire explanation I will do after writing. So, write down, even though you are not. Lifetime. Second note number 2. Lifetime ECL are the present value of ECL that arises if a borrower default on its obligation at any point of time throughout the tenure of financial asset throughout the tenure of financial asset. देखो, credit risk is defined as the risk that one party to a financial instrument will cause a financial loss for the other party by failing to discharge an obligation Point number four. There is a rebuttable presumption that the credit risk on a financial asset has increased significantly since initial recognition when contractual payment are overdue by 30 days correct. Point number five. Accounting treatment. Point number A. If financial assets are measured at amortized cost, the journal entry is profit and loss account debit to credit loss allowance So this is this is shown as a deduction, as a deduction from financial asset. Correct? Understood? And point number B, if financial asset are measured at FVTOCI, at FVTOCI, then Jana entirely profit and loss to OCI, profit and loss to OCI. Means already the financial asset is measured at fair value. Correct na? But that if financial asset is measured at fair value, so that when you are measured at fair value, that loss, because there is a chances of loss, so that loss would have been debited to what? OCI. So now that loss will be transferred from OCI to what? PL. So Jana entries what? PL account debit to OCI. PL account debit to OCI. Correct now? Are you getting what I am saying? So when I am saying measured at fair value, so already measured at fair value, but gain or loss has been transferred to what? OCI. So once there is a credit loss, means when there is an impairment, so that loss from OCI will be transferred to what? PL. PL account debit to OCI. PL account debit to OCI. Are you able to understand what I am saying? Bolo. This is not reclassification, huh? This is not reclassification. Theek hai? Understood? This much we have not understood. So we have not, really we have not understood. But I think thora thora you have understood ki what I am saying. Thora thora. No thora thora. No. So just try to understand what they are saying. Ki any asset, just try to understand, this is the lifetime of financial asset. Samjhenge now. Theek hai? It is very easy from exam point of view because they will give probability of default. The question is that how to measure probability of default. But from exam point of view, they will give probability of default. Once they have given probability of default, then it is very easy from exam point of view. Okay, correct? So what they are saying from the understanding of practical point of view, okay, any financial asset, this is a lifetime. Correct? Now suppose this is the reporting date. So there are three stages. First stage, second stage, third stage. Stage number one, stage number two, stage number three. Correct? So stage number one is that we measure 12-month ECL. We measure 12-month ECL. 12-month ECL means that when credit risk is not significantly increased. देखो क्या लिखा है, what I have written, stage credit risk has not increased significantly from initial recognition means can I say there is nothing happened, you purchase any, you have one loan or whatever, correct now, so credit risk has not increased significantly from initial recognition means can I say there is actually no default or there is no indicator of default. But then also recognize some loss on the basis of 12-month expected credit loss. Means then you need to find out ki what is the probability of default in this 12-month. 12-month means what? From reporting date to next 12-month, what is the probability of default? What is the probability of default? Of course, when the credit risk has not significantly increased, the probability of default will be very less. Means it will not be 25%, it will be 0.something%. Are you getting? But can I say every financial asset has some normal loss attached to that? Are you getting what I am saying? Ki whenever you have given a loan, whenever you have some receivable, there is some chances of loss. बोला कि इवन दो क्रेडिट रिस्क हैज नॉट सिग्निफिकेंटली इंक्रीज, देन ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द लास्ट 12 मंथ फाइंड आउट वेदर देर इज एनी चांसेस ऑफ डिफॉल्ट, वेदर देर इज एनी चांसेस ऑफ डिफॉल्ट, इफ देर इज सम चांसेस ऑफ डिफॉल्ट तो यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट दैट प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ डिफॉल्ट which might happen during this 12 month. So of course, if the credit risk has not increased significantly, the chances will be very lower. The chances will be very lower. Just try to understand. Suppose if there is, everyone just try to understand, if the credit risk has not significantly increased, but if you take entire lifetime, if you'll take entire lifetime to find out probability of default, then it can be higher percentage. It can be higher percentage because the credit risk might increase in some later period of time. Are you getting what I'm saying? Bulaki, if on reporting date, just try to understand what I'm saying. If on reporting date, the credit risk has not increased significantly, means there is a very less chances of loss, then find out probability of default by taking 12 month only. Because if you will take lifetime, so there will be higher probability of default. There will be higher probability of default. So what is the stage one? For any financial asset, first apply 12 month ECL. First apply what? 12 month ECL. So 12 month ECL will be applied only when the credit risk has not increased significantly. So what is the meaning of credit risk, sir? What is the meaning of credit risk? Credit risk is defined as the risk that one party will cause. One party means one, there are two party. So one party will cause a financial loss for other party by failing to discharge an obligation. Means if they will not pay their amount, so can you say, I need to bear some financial loss? I need to bear that financial loss. So if that credit risk has not increased substantially, if the credit risk is not increased significantly, it means we need to measure 12-month expected credit loss. What are the chances of default in the next 12 months? Of course, there will be no chances or very less chances. Are you getting what I am saying? Suppose you have not paid fees. You have not paid fees. Just try to. You have not paid fees. Correct? And what is the lifetime? Lifetime is what? 70 days? So, batao, whether there is a higher chances of loss or very less chances of loss? That is a very less chances of loss because batch is going to be complete in 70 days. So, I know that everyone will pay before 70 days. Everyone will pay what? Before 70 days. But suppose if the lifetime is what? If suppose I say batch is for 5 years. So, and if you have not paid the amount, whether I will assume you will not pay the amount? If nothing has been happened, you are paying on each due date. Suppose I have given you 4 installments. I have given you 4 installments and you are paying on due date. So can I say there is no credit risk, but it does not mean you will not default. Understood what I am saying? You are paid on due date. Suppose the amount receivable is 10,000 and 2,000. I have given what? Installment. You are paid on this date to 2000. It means there is no credit risk, but it does not mean you will not default. Nah. Whether it means it you will not default, it you might default. But can you say if you are paid within due date the entire amount of 2000, it means there is a very less chances of loss. It does not mean there will be no default. So what they are saying, just find out, don't take the entire life. Don't measure lifetime expected credit loss. Just find out if the default happen in, what is the chances of default in the next 12 months? Can I say very less chances? Very less chances. Huh. If I will take lifetime, there can be higher chances. There can be higher chances because as per past trend, I know that if the batch is not completed within time, many students will not come and will not pay the amount. If I am not teaching good, suppose financial instrument, I am teaching bad, so many students will not come. They will stop coming. Are you getting? And they will not pay the entire amount? They will not pay the entire amount. Bolo yes or no? But can I say, if you are paying on due date, it does not mean that you will not default. There is a chances of default. But bola, don't take lifetime expected credit loss. means don't take the probability of default in remaining life. Take the probability of default in next 12 month. In the next 12 month, because there is a very less chances of loss. Very less chances of loss. Therefore, first stage is what? First stage is what? Ki recognize 12 month expected credit loss. 12 month expected credit loss means during this 12 month, find out the probability of default. Find out the probability of default. So what is the meaning of 12 month expected credit loss? The 12 month expected credit loss is calculated by multiplying the probability of default occurring in the next 12 month. Probability of default occurring in the next 12 month. Are you getting what I am saying? Probability of default occurring in the next 12 month with the total lifetime expected credit loss. Means if that default happen, what may be the total loss during that lifetime? What is the total loss that might happen in total lifetime? Are you getting? Means the probability of default will take up next 12 month, but loss will be calculated for entire life. Are you getting? Means already I have given step number one. Check karte what I have given. What is the step number one of recognizing what? Credit loss. Everyone, what is the step number one? I said calculate contractual cash flow that entity is not expected to receive during lifetime. During what? Remaining life. During remaining life. Are you getting what I am saying? This point. So calculate contractual cash flow that entity is not expected to receive during remaining life. Means we'll calculate what? Expected credit loss of lifetime only. We'll calculate expected credit loss of lifetime only if that default occurs. If default occurred during what? Next 12 month. So if default occurred during next 12 month, which the chances are very less, but when the default occur, what can be the probable loss during what? Lifetime. Are you getting what I'm saying? So we will calculate the total contractual cash flow which the entity is not expected to receive because of that default in next 12 month. Because of that default in next 12 month, which is nothing, this you have understood. Then we'll find out present value of contractual cash flow by applying original EIR. That you are expert. Means can I say this is nothing but total credit loss? Means this is nothing but total expected credit loss. This is point number two, is nothing but total expected credit loss. Total expected credit loss. But if 12 month ECL is measured, means if you are applying 12 month, so we'll take probability of default in next 12 month. Next 12 month means if my total loss is 1 lakh, if that default occur, my loss is 1 lakh, but probability of default is only what? 5%. So we'll do only 5%. My expected credit loss will not be 1 lakh because chances of loss is that 5% only. If chances of loss is 5%, how can you recognize the loss of 1 lakh? Are you getting what I am saying? So what is the chances of loss? That probability will be calculated by taking 12 month only. By taking 12 month, not lifetime. Not lifetime. Are you getting what I am saying? Have you understood? Means if I think that what is the chance of loss in next 12 month, which will be always lower than total lifetime probability. Why? Because credit risk has not significantly increased. Are you getting? Credit risk has not significantly increased. But there might be some chances of loss. You can't say that if you are paying on due date, you will not default. You might default. So there might be some loss. So that what is the chances of that loss that you find out? Means right now, means if I am saying accounting standard, what we'll do? If there is no doubtful, then we never create what? Provision for doubtful debt. But now, even though everything is good, means even though credit risk has not increased significantly, then also you need to create what? Loss allowance. By taking what? Probability of default. Probability of default. Understood this point? Correct. What is the second stage? Second stage means what? Credit risk has increased significantly. has increased significantly since initial recognition. Can you say it might happen ki there is some expected breach of contract now? Expected breach of contract means it might happen you have not defaulted, but you are in financial difficulties. You came to me, sir, please give discount because we have some financial difficulty. To dimag mein aaya gaya. I just try to understand. I'm not questioning you. I'm just taking examples so that you can understand my feeling. Ki suppose, just try to understand. Fees is 10,000, you have paid 2,000 due date. On due date, you have paid 2,000. How much remaining? 8,000. Now you came to me. Till now you have not defaulted. You came to me, sir. You said, sir, I'm in financial difficulty. Please give me some discount. And I'm not giving discount, but a doubt arises. Arre baba, 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 baba. Means now there is a higher chance of loss or not? Bolo yes or no? There is a higher chance of loss. Of course, if you'll come me, I'll give discount. Nothing to worry. If you need to say this to me, that you are in financial difficulty. After break you come. After break. Then I will ask second question also. Chalo. So what I am saying, just try to understand what I am saying. Ki if you came to me and you say that I am in financial difficulty, that information is now with me. Ki that entity is in the under financial difficulty, doubt arises or not. Means credit risk has increased significantly, but it does not mean there is an actual loss. This is not actual loss. So now probability of default will be recognized taking lifetime expected credit loss. Ki during the remaining lifetime, what is the probability of default? During the remaining lifetime, what is the probability of default? So of course the probability will be higher. Probability will be higher. Are you getting what I am saying? Correct. So when credit risk has increased significantly, then we'll take what? Lifetime ECL. Lifetime ECL. Lifetime expected credit loss. The third stage is what? When credit impaired financial asset. Are you getting? Credit impaired financial asset means what? Ki due date came. Means first you said me. Ki sir, I am in financial difficulty. Now due date came and you have not paid the amount. You have not paid the amount. Are you getting? So it means now it become what? Credit impaired financial asset. Credit impaired financial asset. Means whenever there is an indicator of actual loss. Whenever there is an indicator of actual loss, means it is near. Actually contract has been what? Was not performed. Means when your obligation has not been performed, it means there is an indicator of what? Actual credit loss. Actual credit loss. It does not mean actually the loss has been occurred. You might come after batch and you can pay me the amount. Are you getting what I am saying? Batch completed, till now I have not received the amount, you have taken the batch. Normally now to gone case. But it might happen you can come to me and pay the amount. So it is in higher chances of what? Actual loss. Then also we'll take what? Lifetime ECL. But you can see the difference between stage number one. Stage one mein interest income is calculated in gross amount. Gross amount means before deducting credit loss allowance. Gross amount. Gross amount means what? If 100 is the carrying amount and expected credit loss is 2, so 98 is the net amount. Gross amount is 100. So, well, interest income will be recognized on gross amount. Means do not change your interest income. Interest income will be recognized on gross amount only. When credit risk has increased significantly, then also interest income will be recognized on what? Gross amount. But when it becomes credit impaired finances, sorry, credit impaired financial asset, when there is an indicator of actual loss, then interest will be recognized on net amount. Then interest will be recognized on net amount. Are you getting what I am saying? Then interest will be recognized on net amount. Are you able to understand? So these are the three stages. So can three stages means what? If I will say this is the entire lifetime and this is the reporting date and till this date, the credit risk has not significantly increased. We'll apply 12 months. After this, we'll apply what? Lifetime expected credit loss. Are you getting? But once it become credit, once it become credit impaired financial asset, then interest will be recognized on net amount. Interest will be recognized on net amount. Understood? Itna samjhe? Now coming from the beginning, what I have said. Impairment of financial asset will be applicable only for three assets. Financial asset measured at amortized cost. Financial asset measured at FBTOC. And what? Lease receivable. Of course, now you have understood that if financial asset is measured at FVTPL, no impairment testing will be done because already the loss has been transferred to PL, correct? Then how to calculate credit loss allowance? First, we'll find out contractual cash flow that entity is not expected to receive. Not expected to receive during remaining life. During remaining life. That is one type of estimation based on what? Default ratio. Correct? Then how to calculate it to find, this is the difference between contractual cash flow that are due under the contract minus cash flow that the entity is expected to receive. Understood this point? Correct? Then we find out present value of cash flow calculated in step number one by using original EIR. So this become total expected credit loss. But this is not the credit loss allowance. Now we'll multiply by probability of default. This probability of default is a new term. Probability of default. So if 12 month ECL is measured, then probability of default in next 12 month take. What is the probability of default in next 12 months? If lifetime ECL is measured, then find out probability of default over what? Remaining lifetime. Correct? Are you getting what I am saying? Then how to measure, how the allowance is provided? Bola, if the financial asset is trade receivable, lease receivable, or other contract asset, they have given one simple approach. Bola, don't go 12 months, then second stage, third stage. Always apply what? Lifetime expected credit loss. Can I say it becomes simple? Three stages deleted, only one stage lifetime. Bola, always apply what? Lifetime ECL. Why? Because can I say generally trade receivable are due within 12 months. So can I say 12 months and lifetime will be same only. 12 months and lifetime will be same. Normally, trade receivable are due within 12 months. So 12 month and lifetime will be same. But like, don't apply three stages. Apply only what? One stage. That is what lifetime is here. So always for trade receivable, lease receivable, or any other operating receivable, will go for what? Lifetime ECL. Correct. If it is not a trade receivable, not lease receivable, not operating asset, not other operating asset, then we need to find out whether the credit risk has increased significantly for that financial asset. Yes, then once again go to what? Lifetime ECL. But if the credit risk has not increased significantly, then we'll measure what? 12-month ECL, 12-month expected credit loss. Now, thora understanding? Thora, bolo yes or no? Yes, you need to say yes. Thora understanding? Are bolna rahe? Yes, you are understanding, I know. So what is the general approach? General approach is applicable to all financial assets except what? Trade receivable and lease receivable. So we have how many stages? Three stages. First is what? Whether the credit risk has increased significantly. Means first question you'll ask, whether the credit risk has increased significantly from initial recognition, no. Then apply what? 12 month ECL. Interest income will be recognized on what? Gross amount. On what amount? Gross amount. Second stage, ki if the answer is coming yes, it has increased significantly, then you will apply what? Lifetime ECL. And interest income will be recognized on what? Gross amount. Third stage, what? It become credit impaired financial asset. Credit impaired financial asset means now it is sure that loss is going to happen. Correct? Loss is going to happen. Then recognize what? Lifetime ECL means suppose that party become insolvent. But insolvent does not mean the amount will not be received. Amount can be recovered as per the judgment given by the court. You know this point? insolvent does not means ki no amount will be received. There might be some amount is recoverable from the private estate of that party, from the private estate of that party. So it means credit impaired financial asset. So what is the chances how much amount we can receive? So recognize lifetime ECL. Lifetime ECL. Interest income is now recognized on what? Net amount. Now net amount. I think you have understood 12 month ECL. I think you understood lifetime ECL. Understood? I think you have understood the meaning of credit risk. Then one note I have given. There is a rebuttable presumption that if the amount is overdue for more than 30 days, means due date was this. This was 30th June was the due date. And you have not paid the amount for 30 days. It means it become overdue by what? 30 days. So if the contractual payment are overdue by 30 days, it is an indication that credit risk has increased significantly. Means financial asset credit risk has increased significantly. This is a rebuttable presumption. So whenever any financial asset, the contractual amount is overdue by 30 days, it has not been paid for 30 days, it means what? A credit risk has increased significantly. It means you'll apply 12 month or lifetime? Lifetime ECL. Accounting treatment, I think you understood. If it is a AC, then what profit and loss account debit to credit loss allowance, so this will be deducted from financial asset in the balance sheet. It's nothing but provision for doubtful debt, but we don't write now provision for doubtful debt. And the financial asset are measured at FBTOCI, then journal entry is PL to OCI. Automatically OCI will be transferred to what? PL to the extent of that loss, to the extent of that loss. This much we have done. So two questions we'll take. Write down the question. On 1/4/2001, A Limited purchased 10% bond of rupees 10 lakh, which is measured at amortized cost. Interest was payable at every year end. EIR is equal to 10%. So it means aggregate rate of interest and EIR are same. On 31st March 2002, A Limited received interest of rupees 1 lakh. Correct? It was estimated that probability of default on the bond within next 12 months would be what? 0.5%. Correct? If default occur, within the first 12 month, then A Limited estimated no further interest no further interest will be received and only 60% of principal amount will be repaid on 31st March 2004. The asset charger. The asset credit risk is very low as on 31st March 2002 यहां पर just write down date of redemption is 31st March 2004. Chalo, this is the question, correct? Calculate credit loss allowance, correct? ठीक है, ले डा। Solution. देखो, since the credit risk of financial asset is not increased significantly from initial recognition on the reporting date. What is the reporting date? That is 31st March 2002. Therefore 12 month ECL will be measured. On financial asset, correct? Understood. Then we'll calculate calculation of expected credit loss on which date? On 31st March 2002. On 31st March 2002, what is the expected credit loss? So they have estimated that if the default occurs within 12 months, no interest will be received and only 60% of principal amount will be collected, correct? So we need to find out what is not collected. We need to find out what is not collected. So write down year end contractual cash flow not expected to be collected correct na? Then we'll find out present value factor at original EIR present value. Have you understood what I'm doing? Batao. Year end 31st March 2003. What is the due interest? ₹1 lakh. How much collected? Nil. So how much not collected? ₹1 lakh. I can write down directly ₹1 lakh, but I am writing in this way. What is lakh? But not expected to be received. So what is not collected? ₹1 lakh. So this is not collected. Difference between due and expected to be collected. Then 04, interest amount is how much? ₹1 lakh. How much collected? Nil. How much not collected? ₹1 lakh. And 04, what is the principal amount? ₹10 lakh. How much collected? Expected to be collected? ₹6 lakh. How much not collected? ₹4 lakh. Understood this point? Can you give me present value? This you understood? 60% will be collected now. Principal amount 60% will be repaid, I have written. So out of 10 lakh, 60% will be repaid. So how much will not be repaid? 4 lakh. So can you give me present value? बोलो हाउ मच 4 लाख 78 74,000 थोड़ा जोर से रे 008 खाया कर रहे तो दिस कैन सी दिस बिकम ECL एक्सपेक्टेड क्रेडिट लॉस This is the expected credit loss. Expected credit loss. Remember, this is 0404. Both are 04. This is what is present value factor? 0.9091. Then 0.844. 8264. Then this is also 0.64. What you have taken? No, only 5 lakh 04 110. Now okay. This is dangerous, huh? I have written 0404. What you have written? 05. ठीक है चलता है इन क्लास डू मिस्टेक एग्जाम में डोंट डू मिस्टेक करेक्ट बताओ वेदर दिस इज द लॉस अलाउंस वेदर दिस इज द अमाउंट ऑफ लॉस अलाउंस नो तो इट मींस व्हाट इज द क्रेडिट लॉस अलाउंस दैट इज इक्वल टू ECL मल्टीप्लाइड बाय प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ डिफॉल्ट In what? Next 12 month. This you understanding? So ECL is equal to 504110 multiplied by 0.50 percentage. Huh? This is percentage. How much? 2521 means. What will be the accounting treatment? What is the accounting treatment on which date? On 31st March 2000. What is the reporting date? 2 na? Yes. 2. Profit and loss account debit to what? credit loss allowance 2521, ठीक है, बताओ इन बैलेंस शीट फाइनेंशियल एसेट विल बी प्रेजेंटेड नेट ऑफ व्हाट, नेट ऑफ क्रेडिट लॉस अलाउंस, तो बताओ व्हाट इज द ग्रॉस अमाउंट 10 लाख, करेक्ट, माइनस व्हाट इज द क्रेडिट लॉस अलाउंस 2521, तो व्हाट इज द नेट अमाउंट 9,97,479. बताओ व्हाट विल बी द इंटरेस्ट इनकम बताओ इंटरेस्ट इनकम विल बी रिकॉग्नाइज ऑन 10 लाख की 9 लाख, 10 लाख, 10 लाख इंटू व्हाट 10% इज इक्वल टू व्हाट 1 लाख, अंडरस्टूड दिस पॉइंट ऑन ग्रॉस अमाउंट, हैव यू अंडरस्टूड, दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड, हाउएवर फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू व्हाट एवर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड रिटन बेकार, इफ यू गो फ्रॉम सॉल्यूशन, ओके समझ गए, मींस आई वुड हैव डन द क्वेश्चन एंड आई वुड हैव सेड दिस, but you should know what are the terms used, because that will be used when you will do the practical point of view, what is ECL, what is 12 month, what is lifetime, correct, these all terms you should know, means from question also I could have explained na, I would have understood also, theek hai, maza aa raha hai, probability of default question, next question, on 1-1-2001 E Limited E Limited has given a 4-year loan of rupees 1 lakh, correct, of rupees 1 lakh, rate of interest 10%, EIR 10%, chalega, interest received at the end of each year, on 1-1-2004 B Limited is in significant has given a loan of rupees 1 lakh to B Limited. Now, okay, to B Limited. In 1-1-2004, B Limited is in significant financial difficulties. Difficulties difficulties. Understood? And E Limited estimate that only 60,000 of triple amount will be received. On due date, correct? Received on due date, correct? Calculate credit loss allowance. Calculate credit loss allowance. Okay. Solution. Look. Evidence of significant financial difficulties of B Limited indicate that asset is now credit impaired. Asset is now credit impaired. Correct. Calculation of ECL. Understood? Now, what question? I have given 1-1-2001, 4 year. 4 year loan. And what is the date on 1-1-2004? So how many year expired? 3 year. So only 1 year is left. Only last year is left. Correct? Only last year is left. So we need to find out expected credit loss. Means on 31-12-2004. Correct. Batao. What is the interest amount? Interest is what? 10% of 1 lakh, 10% of, bolo, 10% of 1 lakh, correct na? It means 10,000, whether it will be collected, yes or no? No, nil, it means not expected to receive. And 31-12-2004, what is the principal amount? 1 lakh. And how much expected to receive? So how much not expected to receive? 40,000. Multiplied by present value factor at 10%. 0.9091 is equal to what? How much total you are giving? 49 45 45 45 455, correct? Can this become expected credit loss? So what is the credit loss allowance that will be equal to ECL multiplied by probability of default over what? Lifetime. If probability of default is not given, always take what? 100%. From exam point of view, because they are into significant financial difficulties and probability of default is not given, we'll take, there is a 100% chances of what? Loss. 100% chances of loss. Are you getting? So ECL, what is the ECL? 45,455 into 100% is equal to what? 45,455. Since because question is silent, if question is silent, always will take 100% probability of default when the asset has become credit impaired. When the asset has become credit impaired, they have given 90%, will take 90%. They have given 99%, will take 99%. Correct? So this is the expected loss. Batao. In balance sheet, what amount will come? What is the gross amount? Gross amount is equal to what? 1 lakh minus credit loss allowance is equal to what? 45,455. So what is the net amount? Bolo. How much? 54,545. But the interest income will be now recognized on what? On gross amount, net amount. So net amount 54,545 into what? 10% is equal to what? 5454. Correct. Understood. Correct? Understood? Come to illustration number 4, page number 48, illustration number 54. In exam, they may ask this type of question. Page number 48. Page number 48. Correct. Entity A originate a single 10-year amortizing loan of 1 million. 1 million means 10 lakh. Taking into consideration the expectation for the instrument with similar credit risk, using reasonable and supportable information that is available without undue cost or effort, the credit risk of the borrower and the economic outlook for the next 12 months. Entity A estimate that the loan at initial recognition has probability of default of 0.5% over the next 12 months. An entire loss that would arise on default is 25%. So what is the expected credit loss? 25% of 10 lakh. What is the probability of default? 0.5%. Entity A also determined that changes in 12 month probability of default are reasonable approximation of the changes in the lifetime probability of default for determining whether there has been a significant increase in credit risk since initial recognition. Bakwas point. So what is the credit loss allowance? In simple, 10 lakh. First we will find out ECL. ECL is equal to 25%. Then we will multiply what? 0.5%. This is the answer. So they may give a simple question like this. 5 marks question. And the total ECL is 25% of 10 lakh. 25% of 10 lakh is what? 2,50,000. Is the total loss multiplied by what? 0.5%. 5% is equal to what? 1000. So 1250 is the answer. Low. Correct. This also done. So we have completed financial asset and financial liability. Apart from derivative asset and derivative liability, derivative point we have not started. Apart from derivative, all point we have considered. And we have also not considered the definition part which are related to derivative. Means whatever I have left definition part, now actually that was relative derivative. Hence, we have not taken the definition part also.